दिस सेशन आई एम प्रियंका बिड़ला असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ENTC इंजीनियरिंग. टुडे वी विल सी द न्यूमेरिकल ऑन बूलियन अलजेब्रा. दिस इज द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस वीडियो लेक्चर. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू सॉल्व द बूलियन एक्सप्रेशन यूजिंग बूलियन अलजेब्रा एंड डी मॉर्गन्स थ्योरम. दीज आर द कंटेंट्स. Now, before moving towards, pause this video for a few seconds and you have to recall what are the laws and rules for solving the Boolean algebra expression. So actually these laws are used for solving the expression. So first law is commutative law. So there are the two laws of addition for two variables. Here there are the two OR gates and here I am giving the two inputs A and B. So the resultant output is A or B. And if we are giving B and A inputs to the OR gate, here the resultant output of the OR gate is B or A. So here we write A plus B is equal to B plus A, or we can say A or B is equal to B or A. So now we see the law of multiplication for the two variables. So for multiplication we have used the AND gates. So here A and B are the inputs of AND gate and the resultant output is A ANDing B. And suppose B and A are the inputs of the AND gate, then resultant output is B AND A. So the meaning is what? A ANDing with B is equal to B ANDing with A. So this is commutative law. Then associative law. So here addition of three variables, you can see in this figure, B and C are the inputs of the OR gates, it generates B plus C. Then A and the B plus C are given to the OR gate and it generated A plus B plus C. Similarly here, A and B are the inputs of OR gate, it generates A plus B, or we can say A or B. It is applied to this OR gate, ORing with C, and here it generates A plus B plus C. So for addition of three variables is written as A plus in bracket B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Then similarly you have to write down for the multiplication. Instead of OR gates here I have used the AND gates. So B and C are the inputs of the AND gate, it generates BC. Then A and BC are given to the AND gate and it generates ABC. This is equivalent to A and B are given to this AND gate, it generates AB. Then AB and C are given to this AND gate, it generates ABC. So in both way you can write down. So this is associative law. Now distributive law. Here there is a combination of AND and OR gate. So B and C are the inputs of OR gate, it generates B OR with C. And then applied to AND gate with A input, this is equivalent to this output. How it will be? A and B are given to this AND gate, it generates AB. Then A and C are given to this AND gate, it generates AC. Then AB and AC are applied to this OR gate and it generates the Y. That is what we can write down in this way. A ANDing with B or C is equivalent to what? A into B, or A ANDing with B, or A ANDing with C. So this is distributive law. So with the help of these laws we have to solve the examples. Now before moving towards, first we'll see the De Morgan's theorem. So De Morgan's theorem is nothing but, here this theorem explains that AB complement is equal to A complement ORing with B complement, or we can say A ORing with B complement of that is equal to A complement and B complement. Means what? De Morgan's theorem, here this is known as the NAND means here this is NAND gate, okay, and NAND is converted into the negative OR gate. Here this is NOR gate, it's the output of the NOR gate, okay, and it converts to the negative AND gate. So this theorem explains that the complement of the product of all the term is equal to sum of the complement of the individual term, or we can say complement of the sum of the term, you can see here, complement of the sum of the term is equal to product of complement of individual terms, right? So this is the De Morgan's theorem. Now we will see the rules of the Boolean algebra. So complement rule is nothing but a complement of complement is equal to 1. Then these are the rules for AND gate. So a AND 0 will get the 0, a AND 1 will get 1, a ANDing with a, here we are getting a, then a AND a complement is equal to 0. So these are the rules for OR gate, and this is De Morgan's rule. Already we have seen, since a plus b complement is equal to a complement and b complement. Now here a b complement is equal to a complement or b complement. So these rules are useful for solving the example. Now we will see the example based on Boolean algebra. So first example, a ORing b and a ORing c. So you have to multiply with this a into a plus a into c plus a into b plus b into c. Now a into a is what? A. Remaining equation same. Then take the common term, that is a in bracket 1 plus c plus a b plus b c. So here 1 plus c, in place of that here we can write down 1. Remaining equation same. Then again take common term in between them, that is a in bracket 1 plus b plus b into c. So again for 1 plus b we are getting 1, and the output is a plus bc. Second example, abc plus a complement plus a b complement c. So a into c, take the common term, which one is remaining? In bracket b plus b complement plus a complement. So b plus b complement is equal to 1, then here we can write down a into c plus a complement. So here instead of a I am writing double complement. This is the complement rule, double complement, right? So here the result is a complement plus c. So a double complement of a is always equal to 1. Here I am writing a complement plus c. Now third example, a plus c into a into d plus a d bar plus a c plus c. Take the common term here, then which is remaining? D plus d complement plus a into c plus c. Now in place of d plus d complement I am writing here 1. Yes, then take the common term, that is a, and then you have to write down in bracket a plus c plus c plus c. So again you have to simplify, a into a plus c plus c, use the rule. Then again you have to multiply a into a plus a into c plus c, take the common term, c is the common term, which is remaining a plus 1. So here we will get a plus c. Then fourth example, a into b into c complement plus a b c complement. Let us assume that a b c complement is equal to p. So this equation becomes p plus p complement. So we know that p plus p complement is equal to 1. So output of this equation is 1. Now next example, y is equal to a plus b, a plus b complement into a complement plus c. So you have to first multiply first two brackets, then use the rules. Yes, b into b complement is 0, so in place of that I have written here 0. Then a 1 plus b complement plus 1 plus ab in second bracket, a complement plus c, then you have to multiply a into 1 plus b, again in second bracket, a complement plus c. So here we are getting the result a into a complement plus a into c. Then this is the last example, a complement b complement c complement plus a complement b complement c plus a complement c complement. So take the common term, and c plus c complement is equal to 1, we know that, right? Now again take the common term from this, a complement is the common term, so b complement plus c complement is remaining. So this is your, here we can use the De Morgan's theorem. Yes, b complement plus c complement is equal to bc complement. So y is equal to a complement bc complement. So in this way, with the help of laws of Boolean expression and De Morgan's theorem, we can solve the equation, we can solve the complicated equations in easy form. These are the references of this video lecture. Thank you.